Hi to all. Today we discuss about the integumentary system of fish. Okay, integumentary system of fish. Integument or skin. Okay, so the integument or skin is an outermost covering of the body. Okay, the skin is an outermost covering of the body, and it is the most exposed part of the body to the environment. Okay, to the environment. Skin is the most exposed part of the body to the environment. So here the skin is well adapted for protection from the injuries and diseases. Okay, so the skin is well adapted for protection from injuries and diseases. Okay, so it is also serves for respiration purpose, excretion, and also osmoregulation. The skin also serves for respiration, excretion, and also osmoregulation. Okay, in some fishes the skin having specially coloring devices and also phosphorescent organs. Okay, in some fishes the skin having special coloring devices and phosphorescent organs. Okay, so here additionally some of the special structures like electric organs and also poison glands also present in the skin. Okay, special structures are like electric organs and mucus glands and poison glands also present in the skin. So skin is the outermost covering of the body, and also it is the most exposed part of the body to the environment, and also it is well adapted for protection from injuries and diseases, and also it is serves for the respiration, excretion, and also osmoregulation. And in some fishes the skin having special coloring devices and also phosphorescent organs and also special structures like electric organs and mucus glands and also these poison glands also present in the skin. Okay, so here skin of fish. Okay, the skin of fish is made up of two distinct layers. One is the outermost layer, and the other one is the inner layer. Okay, it is made up of with two distinct layers. One is the outermost layer, and second one is the inner layer. So here, this outer layer originates from the ectoderm. Okay, this outer layer originates from the ectoderm, and this inner layer derives from the mesoderm. Okay, this inner layer derives from the mesoderm. Okay, so this outermost layer is also called as epidermis. It is called as epidermis, and the inner layer is called as dermis or corium. Okay, it is called as dermis or corium. It is originates from ectoderm. It is derives from the mesoderm layer. Okay, first one layer epidermis. So here this outer layer, that means this epidermis also consists of two layers. This outer layer is composed of many layers of flattened and moist epithelial cells. This outer layer is composed of many layers of flattened and also moist epithelial cells. And here the innermost layer called as stratum germinativum. The inner layer called is స్ట్రేటం జర్మినేటివం. ఓకే, స్ట్రేటం జర్మినేటివం. ఓకే, దిస్ లేయర్ మేడప్ ఆఫ్ యాక్టివ్ కాలమ్నార్ సెల్స్. దిస్ స్ట్రేటం జర్మినేటివం మేడప్ ఆఫ్ యాక్టివ్ కాలమ్నార్ సెల్స్ అండ్ దీస్ సెల్స్ ఆర్ కంటిన్యూయస్లీ డివైడ్ బై ద మైటాటిక్ డివిజన్స్. ఓకే, దీస్ కాలమ్నార్ సెల్స్ ఆర్ కంటిన్యూయస్లీ డివైడెడ్ బై మైటాటిక్ డివిజన్స్ అండ్ సో విచ్ ఆర్ ద న్యూలీ ఫార్మ్డ్ సెల్స్ దే ఆక్యుపై దీస్ లోయర్ మోస్ట్ స్ట్రేటమ్. ఓకే, సో డ్యూ టు ద మైటాటిక్ డివిజన్ సమ్ న్యూ సెల్స్ విల్ బి అరైజ్ ఇన్ దట్ ప్లేస్. సో దీస్ సెల్స్ ఆర్ కంప్లీట్లీ ఆక్యుపై ద లోయర్ మోస్ట్ స్ట్రాటమ్. ఓకే, సో అండ్ ఆల్సో దీస్ సెల్స్ ఆర్ మెయింటైన్ గ్రోత్. ఓకే, దీస్ సెల్స్ ఆర్ మెయింటైన్ గ్రోత్ అండ్ దీస్ ఎపిడర్మల్ గ్లాండ్స్. ఓకే, దట్ మీన్స్ దీస్ ఎపిడర్మిస్ లేయర్ కాంటెంట్స్ సెవరల్ గ్లాండ్స్, దోస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ఎపిడర్మల్ గ్లాండ్స్. సో దీస్ ఎపిడర్మల్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఆర్ మోడిఫైడ్ విత్ వెరైటీ ఆఫ్ గ్లాండ్స్. దీస్ ఆర్ మోడిఫైడ్ విత్ వెరైటీ ఆఫ్ గ్లాండ్స్. ఓకే, దట్ మీన్స్ దీస్ ఎపిథీలియం ఆఫ్ ఎపిడర్మిస్ ఈస్ మోడిఫైడ్ ఇన్ టు వెరైటీ ఆఫ్ గ్లాండ్స్. సో హియర్ ద ఫస్ట్ వన్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్. ఓకే, ఫస్ట్ వన్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్. ఓకే, సో ద ఎపిడర్మిస్ ఈజ్ ప్రొవైడెడ్ విత్ ఏ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్. ఓకే, ద ఎపిడర్మిస్ ఈజ్ ప్రొవైడెడ్ విత్ ఏ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ అండ్ దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఆర్ ఓపెన్ ఎట్ ద సర్ఫేస్ ఆఫ్ ద స్కిన్ బై మైన్యూట్ పోర్స్. ఓకే, దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఆర్ ఓపెన్ ఎట్ ద సర్ఫేస్ ఆఫ్ ద స్కిన్. ఓకే, సర్ఫేస్ ఆఫ్ ద స్కిన్ బై మైన్యూట్ పోర్స్. ఓకే, సో దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఆర్ ప్రజెంట్ ఇన్ ప్లాస్క్ షేప్డ్ ఆర్ ట్యూబులార్ షేప్. ఓకే, దీస్ ఆర్ ప్రజెంట్ ఇన్ ద ప్లాస్క్ షేప్డ్ ఆర్ ట్యూబులార్ షేప్డ్ అండ్ దీస్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్టెండింగ్ టు ద డెర్మిస్ లేయర్. ఓకే, దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్టెండింగ్ అప్ టు ద డెర్మిస్ లేయర్. ఓకే, దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఆర్ సీక్రెట్ స్లిప్పరీ మ్యూకస్. ఓకే, దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఆర్ సీక్రెట్ స్లిప్పరీ మ్యూకస్. దీస్ స్లిప్పరీ మ్యూకస్ కాంటెయిన్ లిపో ప్రోటీన్. ఓకే, దీస్ స్లిప్పరీ మ్యూకస్ కాంటెయిన్ లిపో ప్రోటీన్. ఇట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ మ్యూసిన్. దట్ మీన్స్ దీస్ స్లిప్పరీ మ్యూకస్ ఈజ్ నోన్ యాజ్ మ్యూసిన్ విచ్ ఈస్ కాంటెయిన్ లిపో ప్రోటీన్. ఓకే, సో హియర్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఫంక్షన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్. ఓకే, సో ద ఫంక్షన్ మీన్స్ ద సీక్రెషన్ అండ్ స్లఫింగ్ ఆఫ్ మ్యూకస్ వాష్ అవే మైక్రో ఆర్గానిజమ్స్ అండ్ ఇరిటెంట్స్. ఓకే, ద సీక్రెషన్ అండ్ స్లఫింగ్ ఆఫ్ మ్యూకస్ వాష్ అవే మైక్రో ఆర్గానిజమ్స్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఇరిటెంట్స్ అండ్ ఇన్ సమ్ స్పీసీస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ప్రోటాప్టెరస్ అండ్ లెప్టోసైరన్ హియర్ దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఆర్ ప్రజెంట్ ఇన్ కొకూన్ లైక్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ అరౌండ్ ద బాడీ. ఓకే, కొకూన్ లైక్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ అరౌండ్ ద బాడీ. ద ఫంక్షన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ మ్యూకస్ గ్లాండ్స్ ఇన్ ద ప్రోటాప్టెరస్ అండ్ ఆల్సో లెప్టోసైరన్ ఈస్ అవాయిడ్ డ్రై కండిషన్ ఆఫ్ వెదర్. ఓకే, అవాయిడ్ డ్రై కండిషన్ ఆఫ్ ద వెదర్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఇన్ సమ్ స్పీసీస్ దీస్ మ్యూకస్ ఆల్సో యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద కెమికల్ కమ్యూనికేషన్. ఇన్ సమ్ స్పీసీస్ దీస్ మ్యూకస్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ కెమికల్ కమ్యూనికేషన్. ఇన్ టీలియోస్ట్ ఫీడ్ దేర్ యంగ్ వన్స్ ఆన్ ద మ్యూకస్. ఫీడ్ దేర్ యంగ్ వన్స్ ఆన్ ద మ్యూకస్ అండ్ ఆల్సో దీస్ మ్యూకస్ ఈజ్ సీక్రెటెడ్ ఇన్ లార్జ్ క్వాంటిటీ ఆన్ ద surface of the body. This mucus secreted in large quantity on the surface of the body. Okay, and in Macropodus and also Gastrosteus, okay, Macropodus and also Gastrosteus, here in these two species, using the mucus for preparation of nest for laying eggs. This mucus is used for the preparation of nest for laying eggs. Okay, and also this mucus helps in regulating of some extent osmotic exchange of water and ions between the body fluids and water. Okay, it is helps in the osmotic exchange of water and ions between body fluids and also water. And the next one, poison glands. Okay, poison glands. So these also called as venom glands. It is also called as venom glands, poison glands or venom glands. Okay, so here these poison glands or venom glands have evolved in different families of fishes. Okay, so here these glandular cells of epidermis, glandular cells of epidermis are modified into poison glands, which are present in the epidermis layer. Okay, these glandular cells are modified into poison glands. Okay, these glands are secret poisonous substance to protect themselves from enemy for defense. Okay, they secret poisonous substance to protect themselves from the enemy for defense. Okay, these poison glands are help to protect themselves. Okay, so here these poison glands are generally present at the base of certain structures, like sting, spine of the dorsal fin, tooth, etc. Okay, where it is present means these are present at the base of sting, spine of the dorsal fin and tooth, etc. Okay, so these poison glands open at the tip of these structures, open through the tip of the structures to inject poison by penetration into the prey. Okay, these poison glands are open at the tip of the structures to inject poison by penetration into the prey. Okay, next, photopores. So these photopores are present in the marine species of fishes. Okay, these photopores are present in the marine species of fishes. Here these multicellular glands are developed from the stratum germinativum. Okay, so these multicellular glands are developed from the stratum germinativum. So these glands are deeply seated into dermis and they produce light. These multicellular glands are deeply seated into dermis and also they produce light. Okay, so here these light producing luminous organs are mostly found in deep sea elasmo branches and some of the teleost inhabiting total darkness in sea. Okay, so here these luminous organs are producing the light. These luminous organs are mostly present in the deep sea elasmo branches and also some teleost inhabiting total darkness in sea. Okay, so it is about the photopores. Next, second layer, dermis. So this dermis lies beneath the epidermis and also it contains blood vessels, nerves and connective tissues and also sense organs. Okay, this dermis layer contains blood vessels, nerves and also connective tissues and also sense organs. Okay, so here two layers are present, one is the upper layer and the one is the lower layer. So this upper layer is completely made of loose connective tissues. Okay, this upper layer completely made of loose connective tissues called stratum spongiosum. Okay, stratum spongiosum. Okay, and this lower part is completely occupied by thick and dense connective tissues. First one is made of loose connective tissues and second one thick and dense connective tissues. It's called stratum compactum. Okay, it is called stratum compactum. So here this layer generally has proteinaceous collagen fibers, proteinaceous collagen fibers and also mesenchymal cells. This dermis layer generally has proteinaceous collagen fibers and also mesenchymal cells. Okay, so next, scales in fishes. What type of scales are present in the fishes? Okay, so these scales are derivatives of mesenchymal cells of dermis. Okay, these scales are derivatives of mesenchymal cells of dermis. So in some fishes are knacked, divide of scales. Example, freshwater catfish. Okay, example, freshwater catfish. That means the fishes are completely knacked. That means they don't have any types of scales on the body. Okay, and the next one, certain species exhibit an intermediate conditions. Okay, so means these scales are present on the restricted areas. Okay, these scales are present on the restricted areas. So this type of condition we can see in the paddle fish. Okay, so here in this fish the scales are present in the throat region and the pectoral fin and also base of tail. Okay, so in some fishes these scales are modified into teeth and armor plates in CRs. Okay, these scales are modified into teeth and also modified as armor plates in the CRs and also spiny stings in stingray. Okay, the scales are modified into teeth and armor plates in the CRs and also modified as spiny stings in the stingray. Okay, so here in freshwater eel these scales are very small and deeply embedded. Okay, very small and deeply embedded. That means the fish appears to be knacked. Okay, this freshwater eel contains very small scales which are completely deeply embedded and means it is looks like completely knacked. Okay, so here different types of scales are present. One is the placoid scales, cosmoid scales, gonoid scales and cycloid scales and tenoid scales. So first one, placoid scales. These are plate like scales and placoid scales. Okay, and also it is called as dermal denticles. So these type of scales are mostly present in the elasmo branches. Okay, these type of scales are mostly present in the elasmo branch of fishes. So these are the dermal origin. Okay, these are the dermal origin. Each scale consists of two parts. One is the basal plate and the one is the trident spine. Okay, each scale consists of two parts. One is the basal plate and the one is the trident plate. Another one, cosmoid scales. Cosmos means ornament, idea means like. So ornament like scale, cosmoid scales. So here these are present in the extinct of Crassopterygii and Dipnai and Latimeria species. These cosmoid scales are present in the extinct fishes like Crassopterygii, Dipnai and Latimeria. Okay, it is also made up of with the consisting these cosmoid scales are consist three layers. Okay, one is the isopidine and vascular layer and cosmoid layer. So first one is the deepest layer, second one is the middle layer, and third one is the cosmoid, means it is the outer layer. Okay, so the next one, gonoid scales. Gonoid means brightness, oide means like. Okay, so these type of scales are mostly found in the Lepidosteus and Polypterus and also Amia, etc. So Lepidosteus and Polypterus and Amia, etc. So these are modified from the cosmoid scales. These gonoid scales are modified from the cosmoid scales. So here these are consisting four layers, that means it is formed of four layers. One is the isopidine, vascular layer, cosmoid layer and gonoid layer. So these gonoid scales are two types. One is the paleoniscoid gonoid and the other one is the lepsostoid gonoid. Okay, these gonoid scales are two types. One is the paleoniscoid gonoid type scales, another one lepsostoid gonoid scales. Okay, and the next one, cycloid scales. Cycloid scales, so these are present in the cyclorine shape, and mostly these cycloid scales are present in the teleostic fishes. And also here these layer consist two parts. One is the isopidine and another one is the fibrous layer. So another one is the ctenoid scales. These are comb like structures and these are present in the teleost fishes. Okay, so integumentary system, integument of skin. So it is the outermost covering of the body, and the skin is the most exposed part of the body to environment, and also it serves for the respiration, excretion and also osmoregulation. So the skin contains special coloring devices and also phosphorescent organs, and also some of the special structures also present in the skin. Those are like electric organs, mucus glands and also poison glands. Okay, so here the skin of fish consisting with the two layers. One is the outermost layer, another one is the inner layer. This outermost layer is known as epidermis and it is known as dermis or corium. Okay, it is origin from the ectoderm, it is derives from the mesoderm layer. Okay, first one, outermost layer or epidermis. So this epidermis has two layers. One is the outermost layer and one is the inner layer. This outermost layer is completely made up of platin and moist epithelial cells. Okay, and this inner layer called as stratum germinativum. So it is made up of with the columnar cells. Okay, these columnar cells are divided by the mitotic divisions, and here several new cells are formed. Okay, these new cells are completely occupied the lower part of the stratum, and also these are helps to maintain growth. And here these epithelium cells of epidermis contain several glands. So these glands are modified from the variety of glands. Okay, so the first one, mucus glands. So this epidermis provided with a number of mucus glands. So these mucus glands are open at the surface of the skin by these minute pores. Okay, these glands are present in the flask shaped or tubular shaped, and it secretes slippery mucus which contains the lipoprotein. It's known as mucin. Okay, the function of the mucus glands is secretion and sloughing, the wash away the microorganisms and also irritants. And in this Protopterus and also Lepidosiren, these mucus glands are present in cocoon like structures around the body. Okay, so next, these mucus glands in some species, so it used as a chemical communication. Okay, and in macropodous and gastrosteus, it is used for the build the nest for laying eggs, and also it also helps to the osmotic exchange of water ions between the body fluids and also water. So next, poison glands. So these poison glands are evolved in some many fishes. These glandular cells are modified as poisonous glands. So these poison glands secretes poisonous substances. Okay, these are present at the base of certain structures like sting, spine of dorsal fin and tooth. Okay, so here in stingray fishes, so these are present at the venomous caudal sting, and these chimeras contains the spine of the dorsal fin, and this sturgeon fish contains a caudal peduncle. Okay, so this stingray present a venomous caudal sting, and chimeras present a spine of the dorsal fin, and this sturgeon fish present a caudal peduncle. Next, photopores. These are present in the many marine species of fishes. So here these multicellular glands are developed from the stratum germinativum, and these glands are deeply seated in the dermis, and also they produce light. So several species contains luminous organs. These luminous organs are mostly found in the deep sea elasmobranches, and also some of the teleost inhabiting total darkness in sea. Another one, dermis layer. So this dermis layer lies beneath the epidermis, and also these contains blood vessels, nerves and connective tissues, and also sense organs. So here two layers are present. Upper layer is called stratum spongiosum, and lower part is called stratum compactum, and also this contains proteinaceous collagen fibers and also mesenchymal cells. And scales, several types of scales are present, and here these plate-like or placoid scales, cosmoid scales, gonoid scales, and cycloid and ctenoid scales are present in the fishes. It is completely about the integumentary system of fish. Okay, thank you.